Good afternoon, dear students. This is Dr. Lily Trivedi, and today I am going to give a lecture to you on fundamentals of frog physiology, mineral nutrition. Now, what is mineral nutrition? Mineral nutrition is defined as the naturally occurring inorganic nutrients found in the soil and food that is essential for the proper functioning of animal and plant body. Now, minerals are vital in elements necessary for the body. As you all know that minerals are required, and when we have deficiency, we take the extra supplement for these deficiency minerals. Now, both plants and animals are requiring minerals, and for example, zinc is necessary for the manufacture of proteins and for cell division. Nutrients are required by plants in very small amounts are called as microelements or macronutrients. Some of them include boron, copper, manganese, iron, chlorine, molybdenum. Now, nutrients are required by plants which are required by plants in larger amount are termed as macronutrients, and they include sulfur, nitrogen, carbon, phosphorus, calcium, potassium and magnesium. Now, if we have a detailed look at the nutrients, to explore nutrient role of micro and macronutrients, which is in the maintaining good health of human as well as of plants. Now there is a process which includes the absorption and utilization of these mineral ions for their growth and development, and this is called mineral nutrition. 80 to 90% of tissue is composed of water, and part of tissue behind is called dry matter, and typically it is 20 to 20% only of the original weight. Now, what does this dry matter consist of? It consists of organic compounds, 80% of which is plant cell walls, primary cellulose, and related carbohydrates. Now, they can form gases on combustion at 600 degrees centigrade also. The residue is left in the ash, and plant tissue varies from 1 to 15%, or 0.15% in dry weight. Now, all these elements are not essential for the plant. Only 16 elements have been so far considered essential for the plant. Now, what is the criteria for the essential elements of the plant? Arnon and Stout in 1939 suggested certain criteria that an element must fulfill in order to be classified as essential. Now, what is this? An essential element is essential if it, in its absence, the plant cannot complete its life cycle. An element is essential if it forms a part of any molecule or constituent of the plant that in itself is essential for plant. For example, nitrogen is essential for the formation of protein, magnesium is essential for chlorophyll, and iron in cytochrome. The element must be directly inside the plant and not enhance or suppress the availability of some other element. So from the practical point of view, an element is considered essential only if the plant shows deficiency symptom when they are raised without that element. So the symptom is recovered only by injecting the same deficiency element. So as already said, 16 elements have been found to fulfill the criteria. Now, these 16 elements have been divided into two categories based on the quality. First is macronutrients or macroelements or major elements. They are required in large quantities by the plants, 1 to 10 milligram per gram of dry weight. And what are those elements? They are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus, magnesium, potassium, and calcium. So in total, 9 elements are the macro elements. Microelements only, or they are also called as micronutrients or trace elements. These elements are required by plants in their very lesser quality. quantity. For example, 0.1 microgram per gram of dry weight. Now, what are those microelements? They are iron, manganese, boron, copper, zinc, molybdenum, and chlorine. So, total they are 7 in number. Sources of essential element. Now, what are the sources of these essential elements? Now, they have been divided as mineral elements and non-mineral elements. Now, these elements which the plants get from soil are called as mineral elements. For example, sulfur, phosphorus, magnesium, potassium, calcium, iron, manganese, boron, and many more. You can see from here. Then we have non-mineral elements. Now, these are elements which the plants get from the water and air. For example, carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. Carbon is present in the form of carbon dioxide from air. Hydrogen is present in the form of water from the soil and oxygen from the air. Nitrogen is included in both the categories, the mineral and non-mineral element, because its source is both atmosphere and soil. So they are, now we come to a different part. What is the role of nutrients for different plants or animals? Now we come, the first is balancing function. Some salts or minerals act against the harmful effect of other nutrients and thus they balance each other. Second is maintenance of osmotic pressure. Several minerals, cell sap is present in, are present in inorganic and organic form to regulate the osmotic pressure of the cell. Third is influencing the pH of the cell sap. The different anions and cations have an influence on the pH of the cell sap. They either make the cell acidic or more alkaline. Next is construction of the plant body. Since carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen are elements that help to construct the plant body by entering protoplasm and constitution of the wall. Catalysis of biochemical reaction. Now this is very important because certain elements like zinc, magnesium, and calcium and copper act as metallic catalysts in biochemical reactions. Effect of toxicity. Now this is also an effect of the chemicals, minerals. Certain minerals like arsenic and copper, they have a very toxic effect on the protoplasm, and that too under specific conditions. So I hope you found this lecture interesting, dear students, and from these references I have taken my matter. And in the next lecture, we will continue with the mineral nutrition on what diseases the deficiency are caused and how it is absorbed in the plant body. So thank you very much for giving your attention.